Welcome to the 2015-16 basketball season right here on the Toledo Sports Network. We are so proud to bring you these local games, the games you wouldn't get to see unless you were right here with us on ToledoSports.com. My name is Mike Jameson, along with Mr. Dave Cheatham. We got him in studio here with us.
Jack of all trades. Behind the cameras, now I'm
yes.
in front of
him. And Dave's been with us for a long time, and we're starting off our season here. The Thursday night game with Lake Flyers coming into Rossford to take on the Bulldogs. And
yes.
Should be a good game tonight.
Very good game. Both teams are scrappy. You know, they like to, Lake likes to push the ball. Rossford's got to try to slow them down.
Well, if you're talking about Lake, you're talking about Miss Brittenham. And all of the girls have been able to come through. For the past 4 or 5 years, these girls have just been able to do things that have been amazing. And we've followed it a lot. And, of course, Mackenzie Brittenham has been the one that's been able to be the key scorer here and make a lot of good things happen. Kristen Deal and Rebecca Schwartz are going to be handling the point positions here. But like you were saying, a lot of stuff's happening even before they get over half court with them.
Oh, heck yeah. And these two schools, it's always a rivalry between Rossford and Lake, so it should be a great game.
And of course, Rossford's coming in. Cheyenne Davis, the senior 5'11 point guard, she's been making sure a lot of points are going in there. And they're working inside. You're going to be seeing a Theobalds. I want to make sure. Peyton Theobalds, who's going to be bringing the point, doing our point tonight. Along with the girls downstairs, you got Gazdowski and also Schaller and Dunn downstairs that are going to be doing a lot of stuff. So it's going to be a wonderful game. And looking forward to getting you back out here doing this.
Right.
You're going to get a great game tonight. Stand by. ToledoSportsNetwork.com has got a good one for you. Start of our 35 games coverage this year. That's what we're going to try and do, 35 games. 20 of them will be on CW13 starting at 8 o'clock on Saturday night. We're excited about that. We're going to have our starting fives here for you. And just a second or six, you got to give us a chance to acclimate.
35 games. Oh, I'm excited.
Yeah, I think it's going to be a lot of fun this year. And we're crossing our fingers. We're crossing our fingers that we'll be HD by half the season. So we're going to try. We're going to let Chuck introduce the Lake Flyers for you here. Well, two of the names you're going to be hearing a lot of tonight is for Lake, Mackenzie Brittenham. The Brittenham family Garth, I know their whole family, just wonderful, wonderful people, and they've done such a wonderful job with their basketball. Wonderful girls, of course, Mackenzie and her older sister. Just wonderful here. For the Bulldogs, you're going to be seeing a lot of Gostkowski inside. Look for that. Look for half-court offense out of Rossford tonight, and look for a lot of pressing from Lake. Lake's going to win the tip and get everything set up here with Davis. Looking around. Looks like you're going to be seeing a little bit of a 2-3 zone right now. Moving pressure into some things around. Nice job by Dunn right there for Rossford, and they get it over to Theobald, so she brings it up court and makes things happen. A 1-2-2 matchup here for Lake. A little Scholar over there. First shot of the night. Count it.
Oh, yeah.
Giant Davis with a three-pointer there.
Got the shooter's bounce.
Well, and it was a nice shot, too. Nice open look up at the top. That's what you want to see so far. Schwartz and Brittingham up top. And they're looking it around. Rebecca Schwartz looking for that shot. They're trying to get that ball inside. Houston with the shot. Not there. Gostkowski with the rebound. I think she might have traveled a little.
It was close. She did slide the foot a little bit.
Yeah, I don't think she had it, but that's why we're talking and we're not out there with
exactly.
The stripes on.
Yep. And right now, Lake's trying to get it down to the big girl down there, number 15. Shayla, how you? Oh, excuse me, looking at the wrong one. Deal.
Yeah, Deal's tough inside. Deal's tough inside. Schwartz is moving it around. Still looking inside of Houston. They get it back over to Brittingham. Top of the key, she gets it in. Nice rebound by Schaller right there. Get over to Theobalds. Running the point real nice. So far, we haven't seen any kind of pressing or anything from Lake, but you know you're going to see it. You know it's coming.
Oh, yeah. Lake right now, they're man-to-man.
Oh, nice.
Nice feed down.
Nice. Five-zero Rossford right now. Mackenzie Brittingham's got the ball, getting a little trapping up here by Cheyenne Davis and Dunn.
Yeah, Lake looks a little confused right now in his 2-3 zone.
I think what you're seeing right now is waiting for that shot to happen. It's happened a couple of times. Oh, we got a steal. Oh, it goes right back to first into her. Shots up. Nothing. We got a foul. Alicia Fershinger with the foul for Lake as we start to see some pressure here. Full court pressure from the Flyers. Theobald's having a little trouble with it, but she's getting through. Becca Schwartz. Davis with a nice shot there. Couldn't make it fall. They're coming back now. Houston inside. Just looking. Her and Deal are playing a little catch right now, and they get it over to Brittingham. Brittingham's got it. Oh! Kind of slapped in the face right there. Fershinger gets it. Alicia gets it back out to Brittingham. Brittingham's holding the ball real well.
Yeah, Bulldogs are playing some solid D right now, kind of making it hard for Lake to even get a contested shot off. Until now.
Yep.
Until, see? That's how it usually is when the commentators say something.
on the job for you for over 100 years. You need a career. You need a future. Local 8 can help you make it happen. Join the men and women who build our community. Become a part of a proud tradition. Build your career. Build your future with the brothers and sisters of the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers, Local Union 8. We're on the job for you.
We're on the job for you. We're the local IBEW.
Career begins with an apprenticeship in the piping industry. Our state-of-the-art training facility, combined with on-the-job training side-by-side with a journeyman, delivers the experience needed to become a professional plumber, steam fitter, or HVAC service mechanic. Avoid costly tuitions and student loans. Earn a competitive wage and college credit in an exciting trade. We are the Northwest Ohio piping industry, building the future through dedication, knowledge, and expertise.
MJ Weiss Roofing Company, 28349 Main Street in Millbury, Ohio. For many years, Mike Weiss has been able to put together some of the best roofing scenarios and situations to make sure that your roof is fine. Make sure to call MJ Weiss Roofing, 28349 Main Street in Millbury, Ohio, 419-836-3028. .411 in the first quarter here at Joe Stalma Court, right here in Rossford, Ohio. Mike Jameson and Dave Cheatham got the play for you. Here is the Rossford Bulldogs taking on the Lake Flyers. Girls basketball, NBC coverage right now. Schaller's got the ball for the Bulldogs. A little trouble to get it over to Theobald's. You just had a little trouble with the ball tonight.
Yeah, they are.
Over to Davis. Davis in the corner. Gets back out to Schaller. Theobald. They're trying so hard to get that ball into Rostowski.
This Lake's swarming all over right now. They're just following the ball great. Closing down every spot.
Boom. Allison Dunn.
That was Heather.
Heather got that.
Heather, yes.
Heather Schaller with that point right there. 7-3, Rossford Bulldogs on top of the Lake Flyers here on Thursday night basketball right on the Toledo Sports Network. Chloe's trying to get that ball in to drive. She is somebody that likes to drive, but Coach Simon's really, really got it clogged up in there so far, Dave, and they just can't do anything.
No, I mean, they're trying to shoot the gap, and they're just closing it up nicely, and they're looking down low, and they got double team. Nothing going on right now for Lake, kicking it outside.
Brindam with another three.
That's the only thing about being in a zone right there. You kick it down and kick it right back out. You got a nice little jump shot. Hit the three.
Well, and that's something you expect from Brindam because, you know, once they start, you know, face guarding her, she's just going to drive right by him, and that's always been the plan. Theobald's going in, left-handed layup, got it.
Way to use the left.
Yep, 9-6 right now. Bulldogs on top of the Flyers. Once again, Houston, long pass over to Brittenham. Houston's going to pull one up. Hello.
They keep shooting like that, they're going to take him right out of that zone real quick.
Oh, definitely. We got a tie ball game right now. As Brittenham's got two threes, and Houston's got one already today. Schaller.
Nice D there by Lake.
Yep.
Turnover. Got a chance to take the lead here now.
Yeah, Brittenham's going to bring it up. Schwartz. Kristen Deal. We've been looking at these girls for a long time. They've been playing very well together for the past couple of years, so you're seeing a lot of continuity that you don't normally get to see, and that's always been something they've had at Lake. As Brittany misses, sit over to Schaller, get it to Theobald. She looks down. Schwartz picks it up. She's going to take it all the way, and she is fouled.
It's nice D there by Lake, keeping your hands up, getting in passing lanes, a steal, and takes it in and gets fouled.
Well, basically what's going to happen is they're taking it in like that, and they all just instinctively know that they got to get to the hole. They get to the hole, they're going to get some points. Kitzler's coming in.
And the thing for Lake here, they got some girls that are 5'5", 5'6", and some, they play like they're 6 foot.
Got them both 11-9. We got us a foul.
Foul number 20, Schwartz. It'd be her first.
Yep. Once again, I want to give thanks out to UA50, Bob Lynn, and all the guys out, the pipe fitters right over there on their offices are over there on Cable Road, or Capel Road, off of Oregon. As Theobald misses her first one. And also IBEW Local 8, Roy Gusweiler, and Joe Cugno and everybody. I can't thank them enough. They've been with us forever as she misses them both. And Brittingham gets it and gets it over to Schwartz. It's just a lot of good guard play you're seeing tonight, Dave.
In and out.
Kitzler with the rebound.
Quick steal again by the Lake there, and ball goes out of bounds.
Schwartz is everywhere.
Yes, she is.
She's kind of reminding me of you, isn't it?
How
you
used I'm to play the point guard. I got so many scars down on my legs. That floor does not give, though.
Folks, if you believe that, I'm selling you the Anthony Wayne Bridge before this is all over. The high level, whatever you want to call it.
It's nice having that open now, though.
Mm-hmm. 11-9 is our score. 28 seconds left to go here in the first quarter. Theobald. Once again, Brittingham sneaks one through there, and they're going to hold off here for the last shot. 16 seconds left to go in the first quarter.
Oh, nice.
Oh, there's
steal.
A steal. Dunn's going to fake, puts it in. Wow.
That first quarter went quick.
Yeah, yep. That was our first quarter here on the Toledo Sports Network. We've got all tied up. It's Rossford and Lake girls basketball right here on Toledo Sports Network and CW13.
CW13 and Toledo Sports Network is proud to bring you high school basketball each and every Saturday night starting at 8 p.m. The area's best games for you to watch every Saturday night starting at 8. Brought to you by ToledoSportsNetwork.com and CW13. Mike Jameson and Jameson's Mobile Music is scheduling his 2015 bridal season. I would love to talk to you about your music and video needs for that special day. Now, we don't have 15 different sound systems going out every night, just one, and we concentrate on you and your special day. You will know your DJ. For over 25 years, Mike Jameson has been providing quality sound, lighting, and video for your special day. Call him today at 419-514-1302. Mike Jameson and Jameson's Mobile Music and Creative Video Imagery.
Remember this? How could you forget? Bet you wish you had one of these last winter. Tas Electronics has remote car starters from $129 installed, plus heated seats starting at just $149. No one can stop the winter, but with Tas, you can have a nice, warm vehicle waiting for you. Get over to Tas today.
Tas Electronics. Feel the power. Tas Electronics. It's hot.
Safety Partners Limited has been providing excellence in safety since 1992, adding our Oregon, Ohio store in 2013. SPL Outfitters provides face, head, foot, hand, body, and hearing protection with great brands like Wolverine, Red Cap, Dickey, Wrangler Workwear, and many top safety brands. SPL also carries fire-resistant clothing, harnesses, high-vis apparel, boots, and boot care items. SPL is located in the Buffalo Wild Wings Plaza on Navarre Avenue.
Pub 51 is just a great neighborhood bar and grill. They're about as close to being all things to all people as I've seen. They have a miniature bowling league, and they take that pretty darn seriously. Oh, and a dart ball league, and a cornhole league, and a pool league. They have a lot of leagues. Pub 51 has a big outdoor patio, too. Their pizza and food are reasonably priced, too. Give Pub 51 a try. They're on Woodville Road, just a half mile east of the Woodville Mall.
Taking care of my mother is so hard. All my life, she gave me the best care she could. Now it's my turn. I have to find my mom the best care.
At Always Best Care, our caregivers are matched to meet your needs. And we even give you access to on-call, round-the-clock physician support along with your in-home care. If you need help with your mom or dad in Toledo, call 419-491-7114 or visit alwaysbestcare-nwohio.com.
We have us a 11-11 tie right now. Mike Jameson along with the one and only Sherman.
That's weird hearing you say that.
Dave Cheatham here with you, and Jay Williams giving you the beautiful photography, Kodak quality. So we've got it for you here. 11-11 is the score going in the second period.
Yeah, Lake started out slow, and then turned it up here, hit a couple of threes, and we got a tie game.
Well, you got Brittingham with a couple. You've got Houston with one. That'll make everything run a little bit differently here as Dunn's taking care of the point right now for the Bulldogs. And Hogston's really, I mean, they're playing some heavy-duty man-to-man right now. Theobald's got it. Nothing. Needed. Oh. That was needed right there. They needed that one. That would have been a nice one.
What I like about Lakes D right now, I mean, whoever has the ball, they're swarming two girls at them every time. So
nothing available inside, just nothing at all. As Brittingham's going to bring it up for the Flyers. We got Lake Boys tomorrow night as they take on Woodmore, which will actually be our 9:30 game here on CW13. Special thanks to all those goofballs over there that believe in us. Tammy Ross, I know I give her gray hairs, but you'll never see them. She, along with all the great people at Lake and Rossford and Genoa, they really appreciate what we're doing here. Oh, nice left hand.
Nice take.
Now that's Sherman right there.
That was. And the shortest girl driving it right on the biggest girl there and kissed it right off the glass.
Yes.
Like I said, she doesn't play like she's 5'5".
No. Well, the one thing the Brittingham family has always been and always done. Oh, nice look out to Davis. She's going to take the three. Wide open. Got it. ...14-13 is our score right now. The Flyers are up. Rebecca Schwartz holding it up here on the left-hand side. Scary pass there. Oh, it's bad. Uh-huh. That's what I would be saying. Brittingham, left, right. You never know with her. Manny Hodgkins got it loud. It gets it back out to Brittingham. That's her third.
Yeah, it is. That was nothing but the bottom of the net. You know, I love those shots when you see the bottom of the net snap up through the rim. You know it's a good shot.
They call that a two? I think they called that a two.
Oh, nice take there. Number 22. How do you say her name? Is it K? Kitzler? Am I saying it right? Kitzler?
No, it's Kitzler.
Kitzler, I was right the first time.
Yeah, 16-16, we're tied up again.
Stealing a take there by Bulldogs. She gets fouled. Foul on number three, Maddie Hodson. That's her first team's third.
Yeah, you're not seeing a lot of fouls tonight yet, Dave. But
it's good. You like you're letting them play.
This is gonna be a scrappy game.
Chloe Houston checks in for the Lake Flyers.
If you're one of our 500 or 600 people that are listening on the internet right now, don't forget Saturday morning we have our 106.5 The Ticket. We're on from 8 to 9, and I don't know what we call it anymore, but it's fun. Oh, nice move.
Coast to coast.
Lotzkin, left hand, just what you like seeing. We are staying tight up here. Uh-oh, Davis has got a three up at the top, in and out. Can't leave that open. Boy, you just cannot leave that open.
She had a good look. Just couldn't knock it down.
Kristen Deal gets it over to Brittenham. She missed everything that time. 5:05 left to go in the half here. We are still all knotted up at 18 at Joe Stalma Stadium Court Facility. If you're Rossford, I'm sure there's a few other names. Or they just, I'm sure, you know, I don't mean anything bad. There's names.
Yeah, exactly.
Like a little pet name.
Right.
Like our little Chia pet house or something. I don't know. Kitzler's getting that all the way. Oh, nice job. Gets it over to Deal.
Right now, Lake needs to put a body on him after the shot. So they put no body on nobody. Got the offensive rebound and put it right back up in.
Well, Kozlowski's got a way of just making things happen in there, and she finishes. Yep. Oh, another steal here. Deal with the steal. She gets it over to Kozlowski. She's dribbling, gets it back up to, Beaker. Kayla Beaker, I think. I'm sorry, Allison Dunn, on that. I was looking at the wrong piece of paper.
They broke the press nice. They didn't panic. Had a good look, but just overshot her. She was cutting through.
Well, in the NBC this year, you're looking at Otsego is the game. That's for the girls. The Otsego Knights are what they're all talking about. And then Janelle goes into their home court last week and beats them. So I think any of these teams have the ability to get some things done. As Kitzler with another rebound, and she's going to push it.
Nice hustle right there.
Mm-hmm. Chloe Houston with the knockout of bounds. Yep. The knockaway, is that what they call it?
The knockaway. The knockaway.
Rossford on top, 20-18 with 3:48 left to go here. Schaller's with it, gets it back over to Kitzler. And Dunn, they're doing a lot of stuff up at the point, which is really good. I think they're holding off getting it into Gostowski, but that's where it eventually is going to go. There's that.
Should have been a double dribble there that got away with.
Oh, like
nice
that.
Nice hustle.
Nice hustle. Brittenham with it. Lake Flyers bring it up. Kostowski almost had a nice play right there. She's looking over to Hodgson's. Hodgson's. I want to make sure I say that right. Dunn. Rossford's got a timeout here.
30-second timeout.
That gives us a little time to say some thank yous once again to all of our sponsors that help make this happen. Now, you got to realize, folks, we're just a bunch of guys that are pretty darn tootin' good at what we do, which is sports, television, local fun television. And we would really love to have your help and be able to promote your product. Like, Dave, you got a couple of products there. Don't you want to?
My product.
Early in the season, Dave. The Dave Sherman Cheatham Chia Pet.
The Chia Pet, yes. Put your order in today.
Chia. Are you still doing your internet radio show?
No, unfortunately. We had a great time doing that. I mean,
we'll do it on, you can do it on Toledo Sports Network where you got started. And we're going to open up the, the airwaves some nights here for people that want to do some stuff. So we're back to play here with 2:59 to go in the half. Bulldogs have it, and they have the lead. 20-19 right now. Fantastic girls ball game right now. Davis, Theobald. A lot of pressure up front there, though, Dave.
Staying out of man to man. And, way to hold her ground there.
Well, she bumped into.
I know.
Livingston. Livingston. I mean, she hit Livingston so hard, they both bounced off each other and moved. But they called a walking on that traveling. As Lake has it right now. Rhoda Hodgson's in the corner. She drives. Boy, that's a nice play right there. And Frissinger.
Nice little look. Little 10-foot jumper from the baseline.
Ties it back up. They're looking inside to Skyla. Livingston again. Been waiting for that for a while. Theobald. Nice little 10-footer there for Theobald. Peyton. Oh, look inside. Got it. Nice.
Nice feed. Kicked it off the high glass.
My favorite play in basketball right there. Like the bounce pass in or the over the top, but still, nice job. 22 all right now with 1:34 left to go in the half. Yeah, you talk about one flying. This one's flying.
Yes, it is. Not too many fouls being called. Like I said, the officials are letting them play, and we got a doozy here.
Nice shot up and out.
Allison Dunn just inside 3-point mark.
Oh, just beautiful shooting right there, and they're getting the time that they need. Both teams are. We knew this would be a pretty high scoring affair for a girls game. They just seem to have a way to get the ball in the hoop. Alicia Fursinger with the shot there, she missed. Ball's gonna stay with Lake though. As Gostkowski comes back in, I'm gonna gotta roll your tongue.
Like I said, the Bulldogs are staying in their 2-3 zone. They've been in it the whole first half here.
Yep. Second look. Nice. Brittenham with the three. Doesn't get it. Oh, nice move inside there. Houston again. Got a push, and Gostkowski.
It's going to be her second. Only two team fouls for both squads right now.
Kristen Deal there with the shot. These girls, Lake Flyers, is something they've always been. They have been a team that does not miss their layups. And you're seeing it already tonight. 19 seconds. Heather Schaller with a little early shot there. A little early with 15 seconds.
The defensive player was on her and then backed off like, oh, I'm open. And then, that little hesitation threw her off.
And he's going to take a seat as Rebecca Schwartz comes back in for the Flyers. Get it over to Deal to get the ball in and get up to Brittenham. She's going to mark it down to 10 right now. Going all the way. Going right at,
She is not scared, no matter how big the girl is in front of her. She will put it up, get the friendly bounce, and then take the lead.
Well, that's going to do it for the first half of this ball game here. You're listening to ToledoSportsNetwork.com's coverage of NBC girls basketball right here. And, boy, we got a good one, Dave. 26-24 Lake on top of the Rossford Bulldogs. What do you think so far?
Both teams are playing hard. I mean, the Rossford's looking good. They're driving in, hitting the shots when they need to.
Well, what's impressing me on both sides is the defensive. You know, they're taking care of both sides, and then they're making their shots. There's not a lot of second chance shots here going on tonight, and on both, this can go either way.
There's probably been five or six lead chains, you know, exactly. This first half here, and it's anybody's game.
We'll be back with more. Got to pay a couple of bills. Got to say thanks once again to UA50. Bob Lynn and the gang over there, thank you very much. Roy Gusweiler and Joe Cujo and everybody over at IBEW Local 8 here in Rossford, helping to make these games happen, and all the rest of our wonderful sponsors. And we'll be back with more coverage, high school basketball, right here on CW13.
You've planned and planned. Each moment of your special day just has to be perfect. You don't want to worry about anything. Just know that you've hired professionals to make your wedding day special. Mike Jameson with Creative Video Imagery has produced award-winning weddings for over 15 years. Our company has the equipment and the artistic ability to capture your day on digital DVD, giving you lasting memories of a day you will cherish forever. Call Creative Video Imagery today or visit our website, Creative Video Imagery, making moments into lifetime memories.
Adler Transmissions and Brake Shop, 106 South Main, Wallbridge, Ohio. Your automotive parts and accessories number one store. Your first stop for quality transmission repair for over 25 years. Adler's Transmission and Brake Shop has been providing Wallbridge and all of Northwestern Ohio with quality service. Adler's Transmission and Brakes, 419-666-1010. Proud sponsor of high school sports in Northwestern Ohio. Pro Golf Academies and Technologies and Pro Golf Fairways, Toledo's number one stop for all your golf equipment needs. Instruction with licensed PGA and LPGA Tour instructor Jeff Menor and the best golf simulators in the area. Located right next to Nick and Jimmy's on Monroe Street, custom club fitting with name brand clubs and professional loft and lie capability. Now you can play in 18 holes on our Pro Golf Fairways with over 80 courses throughout the world with our state-of-the-art golf simulator systems. Call us at 419-205-6644.
The Big Apple Deli has all the food for your next party or get-together. The best subs, salads, soups, pasta, party trays, and great, great lunch and dinner specials. The Big Apple Deli, 2118 Woodville Road, has got you ready for all your party needs or just stop out for a great, great lunch.
Stop struggling with the big box stores. Choose Gladio.
Hardware store, yet so much more. Your home improvement answer store. A place to design your interior space. A professional and friendly smiling face. Everything you need for your home. And Gladio is locally owned. You'll be glad to know. Gladio, Gladio Home Center.
All right, third quarter's about to get started here. 24-26, Lake Flyers on top of the Rossford Bulldogs.
Quick score updates here real quick for the first half. Cheyenne Davis with 8 points leading her team and leading the way for the Lake Flyers. Mackenzie Birmingham with 13.
And most of that has been 3-point plays.
And Birmingham has 3 three-pointers in the first half.
Oh, nice shot. Who scored that?
It was Chloe.
Chloe Houston with a beautiful play right there.
Rossford's still in their 2-3 zone.
If it works, all you got to do is shut down Brittenham. How many years have we been saying that?
Many. I'm sitting here thinking, I'm like, wow. almost every year. Rossford in a full court press right now.
I'm being a little quiet right now. Let him watch a little game here. Davis and Brittenham right there. They get the ball over to back out to Brittenham. She's going to look inside.
Nice in and out. Oh.
Houston with just not enough arm on that one. And I don't think she was set up right when she took the shot.
Nope.
Looking inside to Deal. Deal's open, but Gutowski's just right there just to pop it. She gets the rebound. Lake's keeping a little pressure on here. Theobald gets it over to Dunn. Dunn's going to hold on to it and set things up here up at the top of the key. 28-24. Biggest lead for the Flyers right now. Haven't seen a lot tonight with either team taking control with the points.
Like I said earlier, it's been a seesaw battle. Like you were saying, this is the biggest lead of the game by four, but it's pretty much been neck and neck the whole game.
Now they look inside of Gutowski. Two girls right there, Brittenham and, of course, Furstinger, who's been on her all night tonight. They've really been able to shut her down. Nice spin move right there. Boy, you got to make that one. Got to make
that if you get
one.
That down, you know, that far underneath the basket.
Yeah, Deal was there. She had the spin. She was there, and Gutowski knew she couldn't do anything. There's a foul.
It's going to be on Swartz. It's going to be her second. Team's first of the second half. Neither team in foul trouble.
Oh, nice move. Nice. Theobald's. Calling out the assist tonight. That's your job, Dave. You call. All right,
letting them play.
Oh, and they get it over to Kitzler.
Oh.
That's those things that you just.
Exactly. Use the board, but then.
I 10 years of life as a head coach when I was coaching, every time that happened. Actually, I would make them run 10.
Yep. Like, that's what the box is up there. Yeah. Hit it off right off the box.
Hey, it's tough. I mean.
Oh, you're in the game moment. You don't know. You're trying to get it up there. You're nervous still. And
that's a foul on number 15 here. And. Kristen Deal.
That'll be her first, team second.
She's been playing strong defense all night tonight, and it was just in the wrong place at the right time. Theopold's going to bring it up. A little bit of pressure with Schwartz. Held it quite well. Schwartz pushing her left. I like seeing that. Push it left. And there's a steal by Houston. Getting it into Deal. Deal. Oh.
Wasn't looking. We're going to have a little over and back there.
Rebecca Schwartz was hoping.
She turned her head to look and was going to cut, and then the ball came right back to her, and she didn't see it.
Yep. There was the cut, but there. Oh.
She was there, missed it. Better.
Schaller with it up at the top of the key. Picks it up. That ball's going back. Good defense by Maddie Hodgson.
Yeah, Lake right now, the last two possessions have really put pressure on the Rossford Bulldogs and causing some turnovers real quick. Had to steal and now this time threw the ball out of bounds.
Take your time. You know, you're 3:52 left here in the third as we I don't know if my ears are going bad or it's just not sounding right tonight. That's okay, though. Ball's going back to the Rossford Bulldogs.
Probably just us because we're not used to hearing our voices.
This is true. Well, we're excited. We'll have Norm Wehmer for some games, and Steve Taylor, of course, will be back, and you'll be sitting in here, and we'll only get better, folks.
Right.
We'll actually be funny before the season's over.
Only 34 more to go.
A little touch foul there for Hodgkins for the...
That'll be her second.
Yep. Well, those little fouls happen. Not supposed to, but
those
they
were the reaching fouls, not moving their feet. You know, that'll happen. But overall, I mean, both teams are playing real good D. Definitely pressuring the ball real well.
All right, we got a jump ball.
We're going to keep it here. Haley Byer to inbound the pass here.
Up, threw it right to Christian Deal. She's got it. A little help there from Cheyenne Davis. Brittingham's going to drive, spins it, doesn't get it.
Oh. Shouldn't have picked up her dribble. That's when she got caught. You know, the pet peeves of, you know, catching off the glass, picking up your dribble too early, you know, little fundamental things that can easily make or break a team.
301, 26-28 right now, Lake on top of the Rossford Bulldogs. Girls basketball Thursday night. Thank you for listening in to us, and this game will be on Saturday, CW 13 at 8 o'clock. Davis with a nice little tap of the ball. Katowski just blocked her like twice.
Never give up. Never
no,
give
she
up.
She never gave up. Kayla Beaker right there.
Loose ball.
I think we might have a.
Kristen Deal picks up her second foul there.
That's in quick time, too. And they're putting a little pressure on the guards right now. The guards are having a little trouble getting the ball up right now. And. Got to get a little help from Davis right there. Yep. Turnover right there, a little carry of the ball. Saw it, I didn't know if he was going to call it. He called it a little late on that one. 30-26, 2:30 left to go here in the third.
Right now, Lake's picking up the intensity in the defense and putting a little more pressure, it seems like, on Rossford. And
oh, nice. Kayla Beaker, beautiful. Beautiful 10-footer.
Biggest lead of the game right now for Lake.
32-26 is your score right now. Lake, the visiting Lake Flyers on top of the Rossford Bulldogs. We'll be back with more right here on the CW 13.
Conveniently located in downtown Rossford, Ohio, the law firm of Heben, Summer, and Murphy is there to serve your estate, business, and litigation needs. Heben, Summer, and Murphy is a proud sponsor of Rossford Athletics. Contact the law firm of Heben, Summer, and Murphy at 419-662-3100 or on the net at www.hsm-law.net. Go Bulldogs!
The Blue Pacific Grill at Levis Commons is your gateway to great food and fun. A tropical-themed restaurant that offers a unique dining experience where you create your own stir-fry from your choice of meats, seafoods, veggies, seasonings, and our signature sauces. The Blue Pacific Grill at Levis Commons, a touch of the islands right here in Toledo. Join us for lunch and dinner. The Blue Pacific Grill, Levis Commons, Perrysburg.
Mike Jameson and Jameson's Mobile Music, as scheduling is 2015 bridal season.
I would love to talk to you about your music and video needs for that special day. Now, we don't have 15 different sound systems going out every night, just one, and we concentrate on you and your special day. You will know your DJ. For over 25 years, Mike Jameson has been providing quality sound, lighting, and video for your special day. Call him today at 419-514-1302. Mike Jameson and Jameson's Mobile Music and Creative Video Imagery.
Everyone knows Alexander Graham Bell invented the telephone. Or did he? Turns out a man named Antonio Meucci actually made the first telephone. Meucci never paid the $10 fee to claim his patent on the phone. And 11 years later, Alexander Graham Bell filed his patent for the phone. Meucci died penniless and forgotten. Do you have a great idea? Call Fraser, Clemens, Martin, and Miller to protect your idea with a trademark, patent, or copyright. Don't let someone else benefit from your idea. Protect it today.
Two 26 Lake Flyers. This Thursday night basketball, girls basketball, our first game of the year. Thank goodness. Mike Jameson, Dave the Sherman Cheatham, trying to make sure we get everything right. We've only messed up about 102 names tonight. Exactly. So.
Right.
Now, that's not a pass you want to make right there, Kozlowski. She needs to take that ball to the hoop right there. Brittenham's going to bring it back for the Flyers. 6-point lead. I tell you what, Houston's been tough all night long.
Bulldogs right now need to stop and regroup here because they haven't had a bucket here in quite some time.
Yeah, I think the problem has been getting that ball into their half-court offense. They just haven't been able to do it.
Lake definitely has him rattled.
Haley Peters walking right there. Traveling call for the Rossford Bulldogs. They bring Theobald back. Haley Byers going to take a seat. Both teams are playing great, great defense. Rossford just needs to be able to get that ball in. I think the ball handlers for Flyers are just a little bit stronger and able to make sure things happen the way they need to have. Oh, you got a Brittenham on the team. I mean, you say the names, you know, Davis, or, you know, Hodgkins, Brittenham, Beaker. I mean, deal, these girls in Houston. I mean, these girls have been around a while. Like 20 years, you know.
Yeah, right now. Right now, Lake, they're trying to feed the ball down low. Their last four shots have been in the key, getting the shooter's touch off the back of the rim, off five-footers, you know. And that's what Rossford needs to do right now. Right now, they need to work the ball around, try to get an open shot, get a good look, and try to get back into this game.
Well, backside is what's got to help, but that's going to help Rossford a lot more than what they're trying to do, and they're trying to go at them so hard, and it's just not working. They got to work the backside right now so that they can get some open looks for that 10-12 footer, or get it into Grok. Well, Grok's out right now. Grokowski's out. So 103, biggest lead, buddy. Yeah, Brittenham once again. Missed it. Theobald with the rebound. She gets it out to Davis. Davis needs to go all the way. Knight.
Right idea.
Yep. Yep. I think right at the last second, she was going in left. She went right. And then right at the last second, she tried to go back to left. Makes it tough. Schwartz gets out of the little trap right there. Schwartz can take it up, flops it up, and got it.
Little one-handed floater.
Nice shot.
Stepped down the baseline.
Rush down the baseline. Yeah, the intensity's definitely turned toward the turns toward the Flyers here. And you know what? You just expect that from them because they play such good full court defense. Oh, that was kind of weird, wasn't it?
Got away with one there.
She got away with one. Oh,
nice hustle there by Rossford, causing the turnover.
Putting him on the line. Don't forget, 106.5 the ticket. We're on Saturday mornings from 8 to 9. We finish up the third quarter.
Biggest lead of the game by 10 right now. Lake Flyers over Rossford.
On the job for you for over 100 years. You need a career. You need a future. Local 8 can help you make it happen. Join the men and women who build our community. Become a part of a proud tradition. Build your career. Build your future with the brothers and sisters of the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers, Local Union 8. We're on the job for you.
We're on the job for you. We're the local IBEW.
Career begins with an apprenticeship in the piping industry. Our state-of-the-art training facility, combined with on-the-job training side-by-side with a journeyman, delivers the experience needed to become a professional plumber, steam fitter, or HVAC service mechanic. Avoid costly tuitions and student loans. Earn a competitive wage and college credit in an exciting trade. We are the Northwest Ohio piping industry, building the future through dedication, knowledge, and expertise.
MJ Weiss Roofing Company, 28349 Main Street in Millbury, Ohio. For many years, Mike Weiss has been able to put together some of the best roofing scenarios and situations to make sure that your roof is fine. Make sure to call MJ Weiss Roofing, 28349 Main Street in Millbury, Ohio, 419-836-3028.
.36-26 is your score right now. We've got 8 minutes left in this one, better known as the fourth quarter. Dave Cheatham along with yours truly, Mike Jameson, here on a Thursday night, and no snow, no nothing. It's like, it's only almost anticlimactic right now. It's just, you just pull the truck in, load it up, you do it, and you go, and it's so nice.
I'm loving how this weather is right now.
You're a truck driver, too.
Yeah, so I caught some snow last night through Cleveland.
Did you really? Well, you're going to.
I could barely see 3 feet in front of me. Kind of white out. There was about 3 feet of snow or 3 inches of snow on the ground.
Sure you weren't at a Johnny Manziel party or something? He's a good one, folks. He's a good one.
I heard they got Pryor.
Yes. Terrell Pryor is going to be the
re-signed with Cleveland.
Yeah, but are they going to bring him as a quarterback or as a wide receiver? Well, use him both ways.
Them both, yeah, exactly.
That's what they could do with Miller, too. You know, they'll bring Miller in a couple years. You know he's going to wind up in Cleveland, poor guy.
There was a picture, it was funny, for Ohio State. Bosa had his hands up in the air. He's like, you don't want to come out because of first round draft because you go to Cleveland. He goes, I'm going to stay in for my senior year.
That's about how it is, too. Hoskins gets it for the Flyers and gets it over to Brittenham. She's kind of looking things over here with Davis and Schwartz. He's bringing it up. They're going to take some air out of the ball right now. We got a whistle. Offensive foul. Down low there. Huh. Caleb Beaker.
I did not see what happened.
I didn't see it either. I think something had to. Well, you didn't. Didn't you hear her say, "Oh my God, I'm sorry." You didn't hear that? Oh, okay. Sorry. Must have been just me. Oh, we got the flash on camera. I can be Jamie Summers, a $6 million woman. You know, we're all set here. Oh, that's good. You going to give it to her? Is he
gonna, I don't think so.
Oh, it doesn't give it to her.
It was on the ground. Ooh, in and out.
As Brittenham brings it up, she's going all the way. Oh, a nice steal by Davis. Oh, gets it right back. In, out, and in.
And now the Flowers cannot miss.
Yeah, and they're just playing hard inside.
That was the first basket for Rossford in quite some time right there. Finally to break the ice. See what happens here in the last 7 minutes to go. Steal by Rossford. Three-point shot up and good by Peters. Just like that, seven-point lead with 6:42 to go.
Just heard from my wonderful daughter to let me know that she lost the keys to her car. And she's been looking for her car keys. This is her brand new car. And she doesn't.
Oh!
Folks, I'm going to just stop this game. I'm going to walk home. I'm going to find them keys.
We will be right back.
I hope they're not in my pocket. Wouldn't that be terrible? Oh, my goodness.
Oh! From downtown. Brittenham hits another three. Oh, nice spin move up. Ooh.
41-31 right now. Brittenham, nice shot right there.
Beaker with the foul there for Lake.
Theobald.
At the line, shooting two.
Got it.
She had a nice little spin move. Just couldn't get it to drop. At the line, makes the first. Here with her second. She makes this. She'll cut the lead to 8. And she does. 6:22 left here. Loose ball. Have a turnover here by Lake. Rossford's going to have the ball underneath the basket. Down 8. Still plenty of time. They get a nice little shot here and get it up and to go.
Theobald with it right now. Put it over to Davis for the three. Got a foul.
Clear out foul on number 42. Hidowski. It's going to be her third.
Brittenham splitting them right there. Girls, that's why. Get your ball handling down. This is just so important for every team. Stolen by Schwartz. Looks inside. We got a foul. 33-41 with 5:56 left to go in this contest.
It's Theobald's foul. Her first.
Boy,
that hurt. Brittany with her fourth three-pointer.
Yeah, Brittany's playing
well. Actually,
might
have been her fifth. Excuse me, it's her fifth three-pointer.
You get it over to Brittany with the steal. Schwartz over in the corner, getting a little double up right there. Brittany again. She's going to drive. Little flopper. Does he get it? Oh, that ball stolen by Schwartz.
Just thought about it.
Yeah. Hodgson says, "Nah, get it out to Brittenham. Let's play a little Let's move that ball around a little here. We're in control right now. We want to stay right where we're at. Nice move. Kapowski. If the rebound gets it over Theobald, that's the exchange seems to have been the problem most of the time here. Once they get it into a half-court offense, they're playing real well. Nice. Nice, nice. Go in.
Theobald kisses it off the glass.
9-point game again. Lake seems to have an answer every time, though.
Yeah, I've noticed that.
Got a foul?
Yes, I did not see who it was on. Number four.
Kitzler and Peters are back in for the Bulldogs. And
the Flyers, number 15, Kristen Deal.
Deal's in for, and Houston are back in for Lake. Deal. Oh, ball stolen. Theobald's got it, and there's a foul.
We have a foul on Kristen Deal. Could be her third. Team seventh, so we're going to have a 1-1 situation here. Finally, with 4 minutes to go, we are finally in the bonus.
Well, it's just been a very well-played game both ways. You know, we're 9-point lead right now for the Flyers. But these count right now. Theobald's going to make these to bring this back for the Bulldogs. First one.
Cuts the lead here for the Lake Flyers down to 8.
You had to work on that there for a second.
At first,
you?
I thought it was 10. I'm like, the bar was in the way. It looked like a 5.
Got to remember that. That bar has always been set a little too high for you.
Good. She makes them both.
That, like that. I got you good on that. Getting a little closer here now. There's a steal. Oh, she wasn't able to get it. Nice job. Schaller with that. Tomorrow night we're going to have Lake taking on Woodmore. The Woodmore boys are going to be coming into Lake. I always love doing games at Lake. They got it set up so nice for us there. Uh-oh, another steal. Davis with the steal.
Oh, nice look.
Gets it right back to her. Nice job.
Cheyenne Davis with the basket.
5-point game. 4:09 left to go.
Houston. Get the stop here. It'd be nice.
Yeah. They need the stop here.
There it is.
They got it. Peters with it for the Bulldogs. Gets it over to Theobald. She's going to set things back up. Got right in. Oh. Snuck in. Wasn't able to make it. Those are the ones that count.
Yes. Great move. Supposed to be 2-3-D there. Took it all the way to the glass, but just couldn't get it to drop.
They're going man-to-man up at the top. A little bit of a little press. Up, Brittingham all the way, in and out. Theobald with it. She looks, she's got Davis. Davis can take the look, take the shot, missed. Frissinger with the rebound, gets it over to Brittingham now, and Schwartz in the corner just kind of slowing it down now. 3:08 left with 44:39. They're both going at it, fighting for it. Kitzler, nice job fighting for it there, and they get it back out to Brittingham. And take some air out of that ball right now.
When do you start fouling?
Oh, not yet. No. Not yet. I see you with as many times as you've been able to steal the ball. Yep, didn't need that. Oh, and then there's a foul, definitely. Yeah. Yep.
Going the other way with it.
Yeah, Schwartz shouldn't have shot that ball, and then after shooting it, 20, yeah, she got right into Theobald's grill on that one.
That was on Schwartz. That's her third.
2:35 left to go. 39-44. Lake is on top. I think we got it. We got a timeout. Rossford's going to take a timeout, and we'll take one here and be back for the excitement with 2:35 left to go. We are here at Rossford Stadium, and 44-39 is your score right here on the CW Network and ToledoSportsNetwork.com.
Mike Jameson and Jameson's Mobile Music is scheduling his 2015 bridal season. I would love to talk to you about your music and video needs for that special day. Now, we don't have 15 different sound systems going out every night, just one, and we concentrate on you and your special day. You will know your DJ. For over 25 years, Mike Jameson has been providing quality sound, lighting, and video for your special day. Call him today at 419-514-1302. Mike Jameson and Jameson's Mobile Music and Creative Video Imagery.
Remember this? How could you forget? Bet you wish you had one of these last winter. Tas Electronics has remote car starters from $129 installed, plus heated seats starting at just $149. No one can stop the winter, but with Tas, you can have a nice, warm vehicle waiting for you. Get over to Tas today.
Tas Electronics. Feel the power. Tas Electronics. It's hot.
Safety Partners Limited has been providing excellence in safety since 1992, adding our Oregon, Ohio store in 2013. SPL Outfitters provides face, head, foot, hand, body, and hearing protection with great brands like Wolverine, Red Cap, Dickey, Wrangler Workwear, and many top safety brands. SPL also carries fire-resistant clothing, harnesses, high-vis apparel, boots, and boot care items. SPL is located in the Buffalo Wild Wings Plaza on Navarre Avenue.
Taking care of my mother is so hard. All my life, she gave me the best care she could. Now it's my turn. I have to find my mom the best care.
At Always Best Care, our caregivers are matched to meet your needs. And we even give you access to on-call, round-the-clock physician support along with your in-home care. If you need help with your mom or dad in Toledo, call 419-491-7114 or visit alwaysbestcare-nwohio.com.
44-39 is your score. The Lake Flyers on top of the Rossford Bulldogs right now in girls basketball Thursday night edition. And Mike Jameson and Dave Cheatham here. Like to get special thanks out to all the people out at UA Local 50, the plumbers and pipe fitters that work so hard. You know, if you need a good plumber, I guess that's where you got to go.
Of course,
IBEW Local 8 has been with us since day one. I can't thank them enough for all the great things they do for us and all our other sponsors that have been here for us. Just happy. Oh, SPL Outfitters. You got to go over there. It's right over there next to BW3s.
Right, I'm going to be saying that.
Yeah, and check out all the stuff that you can get for, you know, for...
I'm going to go in there. They got the sunglasses and stuff.
They got the sunglasses. They got the warm clothes, even though it's not that cold out yet.
Right.
Theobald misses the first. That was a crucial one right there. They needed those. 229. Brittenham. Whoa.
That was good D. There was no foul. I didn't think there was a foul there. Good no call. Down five right now. They got to press everything.
Now you can start fouling. Yeah. They seem to be able to get what they need to get out of there. A lot of missed bunnies right there. Oh, steal by Brittenham. Ill-advised pass there with Theobald. Missed another one. Well, that's like five in a row.
Right now, Rossford's got a chance looking down low. Quick timeout. Just like that, Rossford Bulldogs are only trailing by three. 1:55 left here. We got a game, Mike.
What do you think? I think if you're Lake, if you want to win this, if you're Lake, you know, the one thing you've been able to do is have ball control all night, you know? And I'm pretty sure that's what Coach Joe's sitting there talking to him about.
Right. You know, in this league here, there's no shot clock or anything. So you got the lead right there. Pass the ball around. Get a good look. If you can get one down low, kiss it off the glass, great. If not, kick it back out and move the ball. Right now, you don't have to score.
Nope.
I mean, at the time, obviously, you know, it's getting down to the wire here a couple, you know, only down three this time. But at that time, you know, you're up eight, whatever. You don't need to do that. Do you think high school should go to a shot clock?
No. I mean, it's eventually going to happen here. But, you know, Rossford right now, all they have to do, and Coach Eric's got to be pushing them to penetrate. You know, penetrate. They got to fall.
Right.
They got to eventually fall. We don't need a three right now. Right. We don't need anything like a three. We take our chances, and they've been doing so well getting the rebounds on the defensive side, too. So 44-41 with 1:55 left to go. Looks like Rossford's going to throw in a little full-court pressure. Lake got through it pretty quick. Yeah, there's another steal. Davis.
Davis takes it out of the way. 1-point lead.
Wow. Who'd have thought about 20 minutes ago, huh? Bulldogs are playing really well right now. Don't need it. There you go.
Good foul.
Actually, a very good foul. Christian Deal's going to the line for the first time tonight.
That was Haley Peters first.
Number 15, Christian Deal.
Christian at the line. Shooting one, or actually shooting two. Shooting two. To lead back to two here. 1:25 left in this contest.
Anyone's game now. Got them both.
Oh. Threw it away and steal by Lake.
Patience, my friends, patience. 46-43 with 1:12 left. Actually, you gotta start fouling now. You got to. There you go. That's fifth foul for the Bulldogs.
Cheyenne Davis, her second. You're saying it's only the fourth team foul? Right now, if I was them, I'd keep fouling to get to the closer to the 1-1, because right now, fouling ain't going to do nothing but just put the ball out of bounds for the Flyers. Kistler's foul, her first, team's fifth. 56 seconds left, Lake up three.
Who'd have thunk our first game of the year we'd get into this? It's all right, smart foul. No, that's a smart foul. Theobald with the foul.
Her second. So nobody really in trouble right now. The only one is Godowski, she's got three, so.
Yeah, we're there. Bonus. Ray Hoskins, who sophomore, 5'5" sophomore, played a little last year for him, and 46-43 with 53.7 seconds left. Oh. Yep.
There we go. Good timeout. Calm these girls down. Get a good look. Call a nice play. You're only down three. You're one possession away of tying this game up.
Well, I think what Eric's going to tell them right now is, number one, no more bombs down the court. We don't need it. You go in there, you know, get yourself set up. We work well in that half-court offense. And Lake is, but they got to get set. You know, they got to get set if you're a Bulldog fan. If Lake is going to do exactly what they do, they're going to put the press on right now. And with Brittenham and Houston and Schwartz and them up front and Beaker, I mean, all of them have just did, and Hodgson's deal. They all can play a point, it almost seems. Great game tonight, brought to you by UA50. Bob Lynn and those wonderful people over there, the Pipe Fitters. Of course, IBEW Local 8. If you've ever watched any of our stuff, you know. And we're very excited to kind of announce that it won't be too much longer before the basketball season's over. We should be full HD for you. So it's going to be beautiful. So you'll get to see exactly what Dave Cheatham and Mike Jameson look like. Actually, I have blue dots over our head. But, that's why we do so well in radio. 46-43.
Is that Faces for Radio?
Yes, we do. I'm just glad we're back. And we need sponsors, folks. So if you want to be a part of this, you know, we'll make it really good for you. Nice play worked out there. They got it over to Godowski. Sending it back up. Peters. Taking her time, going left all the way, looking.
Somebody got to come and help her.
Yeah, you gotta clear that out for Godowski. Theobald's got it right now. Got to attack real quick here. Got to attack real quick. Got to attack. Ooh.
26 seconds.
Got to attack right now. There it is.
There it is. Up and it out. Oh, but it's a rebound.
Got it. Is.
Got a foul. Got to do something.
Right now.
Foul.
Oh. 11 seconds left. 46-45. Hodgkin's going to the line for 101.
Haley Peters with the foul.
Yep, 11 seconds left.
I might have called timeout after that basket there.
First one's up, missed. Oh, they let her in. Oh, they got it. Now you call timeout.
Unless you don't have any, I don't know.
Davis for the three.
Oh, late ball with 1.3 seconds to go. And they call timeout.
Was that Lake with the timeout?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Lake called timeout. They must be out of timeouts. I don't know. I did not see that.
Looking. I'm looking at the clock. 1.3 seconds left. 46-45. Flyers.
I mean, you gotta try to get a quick steal and put it up. If not, you have to foul and.
And 1.3, you might be able to get something off here. You know, the Flyers have not been able to hit anything from the line. Nothing.
Right now you just need to box out, get the ball, and it's been a good game though. It's been a seesaw battle. Can't complain.
If we complained, who would listen?
Exactly.
Anybody knows us knows. Yeah, it's just those idiots. Just let them talk. I'll buy a hamburger at McDonald's or something. All right, here we go. 1.5 seconds left. Deal's got it. Oh,
tip. I don't know if the whistle before the. They are calling it.
Well, that's your final tonight. 46-45 as we start the. High school basketball season here on the Toledo Sports Network and CW13. Stick around. We got a few things for you here, and we will be back after we pay a couple of bills right here on the Toledo Sports Network.
Pub 51 is just a great neighborhood bar and grill. They're about as close to being all things to all people as I've seen. They have a miniature bowling league, and they take that pretty darn seriously. Oh, and a dart ball league, and a cornhole league, and a pool league. They have a lot of leagues. Pub 51 has a big outdoor patio, too. Their pizza and food are reasonably priced, too. Give Pub 51 a try. They're on Woodville Road, just a half mile east of the Woodville Mall.
Could you forget? Bet you wish you had one of these last winter. Tas Electronics has remote car starters from $129 installed, plus heated seats starting at just $149. No one can stop the winter, but with Tas, you can have a nice, warm vehicle waiting for you. Get over to Tas today.
Tas Electronics. Feel the power.
Tas Electronics.
It's hot.
Burger Bar 419. Our heart is good, flipping burgers and sides. It's the quality, taste, and love put into everything we serve that sets us apart from the others. It's the comfort food we were brought up on, with a fresh hip twist. Simple, fresh, and delicious offerings for everyone, meat eaters and vegetarians. Our soul is our support for local business. Our fresh beef is ground by the butcher 200 feet from our front door. Burger Bar 419. Good flipping burgers.
.45 is your final tonight in girls basketball, our first basketball game of the year here on ToledoSportsNetwork.com and CW13. Mike Jameson, Dave Sherman Cheatham. Did I spell that Cheatham right there?
It looks right, yeah.
Okay, cool, perfect. Cool. Wonderful game. You couldn't ask for a better start for the season here, Dave. And what we got to see a lot of tonight was a lot of tenuous defense, huge defense. And Rossford just has to work on getting their ball handling down.
Oh, yeah, they get that taken care of, they're going to be a good team. I mean, obviously, it's early in the season right now. You know, a little shaky. Our Lake defense was just swarming all over them. Right?
Well, something we talked about even before the game was, Otsego being such a perennial, they're the team to beat. Genoa came in, the girls came into Otsego and beat them. So I think everything is wide open this year. Lake looks like they're going to be a really good squad. Same with Rossford. You got some numbers for us?
Yeah, right now, leading scorer for Lake was Mackenzie Brittingham. She had 19, 5 3-pointers.
Yes.
I mean, it's hard to stop. And then Hudson had 7. And then for Rossford, leading scorer, Theobald, had 14. And then Davis had 12.
Well, something you saw with Rossford, too, they made their free throws when they needed to make their free throws.
Right.
That was good for them. Boxing out, got themselves in a little bit of foul trouble, not too much tonight. But I think what you're seeing once again with Lake is that ability to play defense in the backcourt. And it's going to be very tough for any team to be able to, you know, get through that unless they can handle the ball well.
Right. Well, Rossford had a chance. I mean, they were down 5 there going there, a few minutes left in the game, and they just couldn't convert.
Right.
You know, they had chances there, a couple bunnies they missed. They were at the line. Theobald was at the line, had a 1-1. She missed the front end of the 1-1. So they had their chances. So, I mean, I tip their hats to them. They played a great game.
Well, we're going to have a lot of girls basketball for you in the NBC conference this year. We're going to try and do 3 games a week for you. Our Tuesday night games, we're going to do some track games, some tack games. Those will just be on the internet because, I mean, we've got the internet. Everybody talks about our internet. Sign up at Toledo Sports Network on Facebook so you can give us some comments and, maybe we'll do a game for you.
Right.
You know,
right.
We're all over. We've got 1 million-plus people that are able to watch this throughout northwestern Ohio. So thank you for watching tonight and being part of CW13. And, Dave, thank you.
Thank you.
You did a wonderful job. And, of course, Jay Williams behind the camera there. And what do you do? Folks, we'll see you later. Oh, don't forget, we've got another game right after this. We're with Woodmore Lake Boys. And next week, we've got some great games, too. So stick around, and thank you for watching the Toledo Sports Network right here on CW13.